name, please?
My name is Tanmay, Tanmay Kamar.
You're an engineer?
Yes, sir.
Civil engineer?
No, sir, I am an electronics engineer.
Okay. Presently, you are working somewhere?
Yes, sir, I am working as the Tehsil Welfare Officer in Jubbal.
Can you name the upper house and lower house of Indian Parliament?
So the upper house is known as the Rajya Sabha and the lower house is known as the Lok Sabha.
How they are elected?
So the people elected to the Lok Sabha are elected directly through parliamentary elections, and the people in Rajya Sabha are elected by various means. For example, by MLAs of the states, and some are nominated as well.
And what is this judicial review?
The judicial review is a process in which any legislations which are passed by the parliament are subject to review under the courts of India. For example, high courts or the Supreme Court.
Indian constitution is unitary or federal?
It's a federal constitution with some unitary features.
With some unitary bias.
Unitary basis, yes, sir.
And what is the method of amendment to Indian constitution?
So there are various methods of amendment to the Indian constitution, for example, by simple majority and special majority.
There is a talk of Indian parliament being renovated or rebuilt. What is that?
So they are considering changing some of the British era structures of Delhi, for example, Indian Parliament and the South Block. So they are trying to give it a look which is modern in character, modern Indian character.
But some other need also?
Some
restraints in terms of parking or?
They are trying to locate all the offices of every MP, and they are also trying to create a place which in which there is a building where only Lok Sabha will take part and another building where only Rajya Sabha will sit.
Recently there was a cyclone known as Bulbul.
Yes, sir.
It affected which states?
So it affected Odisha, West Bengal. Most of the damage was in these states.
What do you know about Article 370?
Article 370 is an article which concerned some of the special provisions, and they were temporary in character concerning the state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Mm.
And according to this article, Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir had a tenure of 6 years, and there are various other features. For example, sir, it had a separate constitution and it had a separate flag. So these were some of the provisions of Article
370. Now it has been abolished.
It has been diluted. It has not been abolished.
It has been diluted by way of amendment to the constitution or what?
No, so it's it has been diluted by way of presidential order.
Sir.
You must have heard about Greta Thunberg.
Yes, sir.
What is her contribution?
So she is a teenager and who is concerned about the environmental degradation which has been occurring over the past few years, and she is more concerned about the climate change and such processes which have been damaging the environment. And recently she gave a speech in UNFCCC.
Do you think some impact she is leaving, some impact on which section of society the impact you can
notice? So she may be impacting the younger generations, because at her age, if she is concerned about environment, so she is trying to influence the younger generations, and also some of the impact may be left on the older people, older guard, who have been leading the various states. That if a younger girl can be such impacted by the policies of various states, so we can also bring about a change in this world.
But do you think younger generation needs to be oriented in this, or
it's the need of the hour, because much has been done, not much has been done in this field. There are various conventions, various treaties, but still the world is suffering from climate change, and therefore the younger generations need to be aware about it.
Recently, Venice was in news. For what?
Sir, I don't know about that.
Because it's all mostly submerged in water. So this time the water came up. And so every year this one mm water, the level is increasing.
Right.
That was in the beauty. Our new government has brought in a new mantralaya, Jal Shakti mantralaya. What are the basic comes under its purview?
So the Jal Shakti Jal Shakti Ministry is the same which was Ministry of Water Resources. And
just water resources? Or?
Water resources, Ganga Rejuvenation, okay. And there was one more aspect, I'm not remembering that now. And sir, it concerns about taking care about the water resources of the country, as well as taking care about rejuvenation of various rivers, and also the National Ganga Mission.
The ministry is very upbeat because some good amount of allocation, budgetary allocation has been made. Can you have an idea what kind of?
Sir, I don't remember.
So 10,000 crore has been made into it. And do you think it's what kind of water, with regard to water, say, in India? Otherwise in the world we talk about it as a private good, or maybe in India we talk about a public good, but in India water is God, it's not good. Do you think that this right from changing this perception from God to good and good to private good is for good, or it's quick to really?
So, I'm not able to get the question.
The question is very simple. Today water is considered to be as a resource.
Yes.
So it is now, you buy a bottle, it's a consumer, it becomes an object, it becomes something which you can trade.
Yes.
But whereas water has not to be a trade, in India it was just not for the public good, it was something to be worshipped. So you are very, very, each and every member. Now we think that Nal Se Jal, that's the kind of government we are planning. It becomes an entitlement. Then it was not entitlement, then water was our, not just asset, but it was some resource which had to be,
yes,
I mean, taken care of also. So from that angle, this kind of deterioration in the perception of the society, is it good for the society?
I don't think that, sir, this is good for the society, because we need to have water resources at our disposal, and according to various sources and reports, the per capita availability of water is going to significantly reduce in 2030. So, despite having rivers which we are worshipping like goddesses, and we are not able to fulfill our needs because we are polluting those rivers, and therefore there is a need to use that water as a good now, because we have not been able to get anywhere by treating water as God. So, we need to treat it as a good.
Treat it as a good. Now, you said you treat it as good only.
Yes, sir. We need to treat, because it hasn't gotten us anywhere by treating them as goddesses and water as God.
Is the role of yoga today, is it government is really taking care of it and really promoting it? So Yoga Day is just kind of celebrated in a big way.
Yes.
Chandigarh has got a connection with Yoga Day.
So the last year International Yoga Day was celebrated in Chandigarh.
18?
Sorry.
Or was it 16?
Sir, it's
2002. Second Yoga Day was just
2017.
Yeah. The Prime Minister himself.
Yes, he came in Chandigarh.
What is yoga?
So yoga is combining our physical and mental state in a unified manner. When our physical and mental state are one.
Is it a system of philosophy, or is it a system of life?
It's a philosophy according to ancient Indian traditions.
Philosophy only, or more practice also?
It's a philosophy as well as a practice. When we are following that philosophy, it manifests itself into a practice.
If you consider yourself to be a good leader, what is your topmost attribute which you think that defines you?
So when I'm a good leader, I think that I can lead by example, and I can influence people, because I like to work in cooperation with everyone. And I do not like to be authoritative, and I do not like to direct people. I want them that they should do their work of their own will, and or due to their feeling for doing something good.
Heard about this Nai Rahein Nai Manzil?
Yes, sir. This is a scheme.
What is that?
It's a scheme which has been followed by the government of Himachal Pradesh. And in this scheme, the government is looking forward to explore new places of tourism, which are yet unexplored in this state.
Do you think enough destination branding has been done in Himachal to promote tourism?
No, sir. And up until now, it's not been that much influencing the advertisement, because various states are having their ads published on the TV, like Madhya Pradesh and even some northeastern states. But still, Himachal has not been able to advertise it on television. And there were talks about promoting our tourism and various aspects of our tourism on various railway stations as well as airports in the last tourism policy. But still, that has not been done yet. Therefore, some more steps are to be needed and to promote this area.
Tanmay, how you write, how your name has been written in your matric certificate?
It's Kamar Tanmay.
Kamar Tanmay. Yes. Not Tanmay, Kamar.
Not
Kamar. And I see that you have given references, one from Chamba and the second from other part of the state. Any reason for this?
Sir, I have been visiting because my mother's parents are in Chamba. So I keep visiting Chamba, and then I'm working in Jubal, and I stay in Shimla.
Mm-hmm.
So various places I have been going around.
Okay. Is there some fair, very important fair in Chamba that takes place?
It's Minjar.
What is Minjar?
Minjar are parts of maize which are used to start this fair, and these were the process of submergence of Minjar was started during time of Sahil Varman,
mm-hmm.
and since then this process has been followed.
I see. And your parents' side is from Jubal?
No, sir. My father is from Mandi.
Mandi.
Yes, sir.
All right. So the fair of Mandi, let me know.
So it's the major attraction of Mandi is Shivratri.
Shivratri.
Yes,
I see. Do you know any past when you go to the place you have given the address of Siunta? When you go to Chamba, is there any past? There's some past also, or
this is
you
the
go
reference of my friend that I'm not Chamba, in Siunta.
Mm-hmm.
So, you're asking about the past while I was visiting
mm-hmm.
from Chamba to Chamba.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, just wait. Sir, I don't remember any
place. Any tribal area which touches Chamba?
So the tribal area within Chamba, it's Pangi and Bharmaur subdivision, and around Chamba, it's the Lahol area which is touching Chamba.
That also touches Chamba. Tanmay, are you aware of Right Information Act? Any important ruling that might have come with regard to this?
So recently, the central government has amended the Right to Information Act and has...
I'm talking about court ruling.
Yes, sir. The Supreme Court has added that Chief Justice of India would fall under the Right to Information Act.
In which capacity?
Sir, being a public authority.
What is the role of public authority?
So the role of public authority is to maintain governance structure in the country so that and provide various services as well so that the country runs in a proper and proper manner.
So it means if there is a public authority in your department of welfare, you work in the department of social justice and empowerment.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
So if there is a public authority in SJE, its duty is to maintain all things in the country?
So in the
public authority of your department?
It concerns with the Department of Social Justice and Empowerment. So it depends upon the rank of the authority and its jurisdiction.
I see. Which is authority responsible for supplying of information to RTI?
Sir, it's the Central Information Commission.
No, I repeat my question. Which is the authority under RTI responsible to supply the information to the applicant?
It's a public information officer in the various departments.
You have mentioned that you play online game. You do online gaming. Why you are hooked to it?
It's because it's really addictive, and once you start playing it, you feel like playing it all the way when you are free.
Would you encourage the generation younger to you to develop this hobby?
I would suggest them that if they have free time and when they are in holiday mood, they can play it, but not much. For example, 1 or 2 hours. And they should be encouraged more towards outside games, outdoor games.
You have yourself admitted that it is addictive.
Yes. But still, because children are, they can be molded anyway. And we're not in that stage that we can be molded that easily, so.
Okay. And which TV series is your favorite?
So it's Game of Thrones.
And up to which level you have played cricket? You are representing college or university or what?
So I have during school times we used to play with each other. And during college times I played at the inter-branch level within various branches. So that was the time I played, and the last time I played cricket.
Do you watch cricket also?
Yes, sir, I watch cricket.
What do you think about Indian cricket team?
It's at the moment it's one of the strongest and the most and the best cricket team, which can be said of and at the world level as well as and if we see Indian cricket all over the years, and the bowling attack has been strengthened, which was not the case earlier.
Which body controls the management of cricket in India?
It's the Board of Cricket Control in India, BCCI.
Anybody from Himachal who might be
concerned? So he's Anurag Thakur.
Anurag Thakur.
Yes, sir.
Are you sure about it?
Yes, sir.
But I don't think he exists. He's there now.
He's not currently. He was earlier the president of BCCI.
I want to know if there's any person who's currently holding the post.
Currently, I don't know, sir. If there's someone.
Tell me, you, how much of Himachal have you seen?
So I have not visited many places, but places which I have gone for the sake of wandering are Spiti area and Prashyar area, and I have been visiting Chamba because of my grandparents and my village.
Can you tell me the important monasteries of Spiti?
There are various monasteries in Spiti, and the most famous one is Tabo. Then there is Dhankar Monastery and the Shakya Monastery in Kaza.
What is so special about Spiti? How it is different from other areas?
So it's different from other areas because it's in the Trans-Himalayan region. And it's like a cold desert. And various other areas of Himachal Pradesh, they are not that dry, and it witnesses the least amount of rainfall in Himachal Pradesh. So it's different from the rest of the areas.
Let's see. And does it have a different system of administration? Do you have the same system of administration in Simla and the same in Spiti?
No, so the system of administration is different because in Shimla we have the normal administration. But in Spiti, we have single line administration.
What is it?
So in this administration, the concerned DC or the DM has the power to sanction various schemes and various money which comes into that area, and he has the power to sanction that.
DC Shimla also has powers to sanction money.
But sir, for example, in Shimla, like we are reporting to the district welfare officer. But in those districts, the concerned officers will report directly to the DM.
What is the benefit of single administration? Why?
Because the tribal areas of our Himachal Pradesh, they require more care and more attention and more funds. So if there are, if the authority to sanction those funds is the same, so the projects which have to be implemented in those areas, it will fast track those projects and not take time consuming exercises.
You mean like that these areas need more funds?
Yes.
Is there, have we developed a mechanism whereby more funds can be devolved to these areas?
Yes sir, we have devised the tribal sub plan which has been implemented.
Any decision in principle that this much fund would be allocated to TSP?
It's according to the percentage of the tribes which reside in those areas, plus there is the amount of area and the amount of backwardness. So this is the criteria which is being followed in Himachal Pradesh.
But there's no decision as such that this much fund would be earmarked for.
It's not fixed, sir. It's according to the backwardness and population and
No, I'm
area.
Talking about the entire tribal area.
So it's a fixed various percentages for the proper tribal areas fixed. For example, in Kinnaur we have around 30%.
No, again you are coming to Kinnaur. I'm saying that is there any decision of the government to earmark given percentage under tribal supply?
I don't remember this.
Please.
Right, Tanmay, what is the fleet of fighter aircrafts that our IAF possesses, Indian Air Force possesses?
I don't know the exact
number. Do you have an idea about Rafale?
Yes.
So what is the offset clause in the Rafale deal?
So it's the offset clause concerns that 30% of the 30% of the money which has been invested in that deal, it should be invested in India itself, and which will going forward will be increased to 50%.
Anything else?
And the content of I don't know sir, much else about it.
Okay. Which aircraft did we use for the Balakot strike?
It was MiG-21 Bison and Sukhoi, and the Mirage.
Mirage or Sukhoi?
Mirage, sir.
Mirage have been we have imported from which country?
So the Mirage have been imported from France.
Good. Where is Balakot located?
It's in the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province of Pakistan.
Good. Recently there have been talks about the merger of ITBP and Assam Rifles.
Yes.
So are you aware of it?
Yes.
So would you like to tell something to the panel about it?
Sir, there was since there are various forces which have been defending the borders of India, so to create an integrated command and integrated force, so there were talks about merging Assam Rifles and ITBP. But there have been opposition because there are two forces, two departments, two ministries which are controlling Assam Rifles, Ministry of Defence as well as Ministry of Home Affairs.
ITBP is not very happy about it, not very excited about it.
Then we can differentiate between Amrit cities and smart cities.
Smart cities have been selected through a list which has been released every year by Ministry of Urban Development. And there are certain cities which also need care and attention and development. But which cannot come in smart cities, so they have been covered under the Amrut scheme.
Have we specified any number for that?
There have been, we have to develop around 100 smart cities every year, and there will be earmarking of 100 crores to each of these cities over 5 years period.
100 crores, sure.
I'm not sure about the allocation.
And what about the number of Amrut cities?
Yeah. They can be more than the smart cities, and their list has been. I don't think, ma'am, the list of the Amrit cities is released every year.
Shimla is coming under which category? We belong to Shimla district.
It's in the smart city project.
What is your definition of smart city?
According to me, smart city is a city which is ICT, which has ICT enabled infrastructure in itself, and which is a digitally empowered city, and with all the modern amenities. Plus, there is care about inclusive growth and sustainable development as well.
You did your engineering from NIT, is NIT a deemed university?
Yes.
What is the difference between a deemed university?
For example, the deemed university is a university in which the decisions concerning the management of the college and all the constructions and all those decisions which are concerning that college, plus checking of the examinations, it is undertaken by the college administration itself. But in the non-deemed university, for example, like Baddi University used to be a non-deemed university, so the decisions and the management of that institute was taken by Himachal Pradesh University, and the examinations were checked also in HPU.
Anything related to academic autonomy?
When the deemed university can decide its own syllabus, while the non-deemed university cannot.
So you have visited Chamba also.
Yes.
Any specific national level program in which Chamba district has been selected? Or it has been considered as a district where there is a scope for development at the national level?
SOMIT has been selected under transformational aspirational district programs by the Niti Aayog.
Why Chamba only? Why not other districts?
Because it's the most backward state of Himachal Pradesh. District of Himachal Pradesh.
Backward in what sense?
In development of infrastructure and various other aspects like health, education. For example, these areas, it's the most backward district of Himachal Pradesh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We can wait for your feedback. We'll take your feedback. Take a piece of paper. Just note it down.
Sir, please.